Carlos?
Yes.
How you doing?
All right, everyone, I'm heading to Union Station right now in the city. I gotta take the train though, so I just got out of the Uber to get on the Brown Line. And right now I'm starving, so I'm gonna get a bit of breakfast before I go. Alright guys, so I'm at Union Station right now. It is 10:57. My train is at 11:33, so still have a few minutes. But basically, if you guys didn't watch my last video, I've been done with school since like the 6th of December. We officially ended the 12th, so I'm actually on break right now, which is really exciting. Right now I'm heading to Oak Brook, which is a west southwest suburb of Illinois and Chicago, and I'm gonna see a friend there. I'm waiting at Union Station. I'm gonna take the Metro train in a bit and then head over there. I think it's maybe like a 40-minute ride, so not too bad. It's gonna pick me up from the station, and yeah, I'll pick it back up in the next few clips. Yo! Okay, everyone, I'm here with my friend James. We're in Oak Brook. But I just remember when I was checking through my bag that I forgot my second battery, like an idiot. So that's at home, meaning my camera's gonna die because it's at 10%. So the second part of this video, when I get back home and pick it back up, is going to be me reflecting on my fall quarter of 2021 in college and actually going over all my classes and what grades I got. So guys, please stay tuned for that. It's gonna be, I think, really informative and helpful for all of you. So if you're interested, please stick around and I will pick it back up when I actually get home. Thanks, guys. All right. If you guys are watching up until this point, I wasn't able to actually record a lot of footage yesterday when I was in Oak Brook just because my camera battery did die and I forgot to bring another one. I thought the one I had would be enough to record for the day because it usually is a very long lasting one, but it's all good. So I just finished college a few weeks ago and grades actually just came in this past Monday. So my fall quarter is officially done. I figured since I did it with all my other quarters and I started last year for freshman year, I'll continue to do the reflections. So I'm gonna be talking about my fall quarter in the whole and really focusing on the four classes I took. So if you missed my last video, the four classes I took this quarter were Spanish 121-1, which was intermediate Spanish, Business Institutions 301, which was an accounting class, RTVF 190, which was my production class, and then RTVF 220, which was like a seminar style media analysis type writing class. So starting off from the bottom with Spanish, I took two of these classes last year. I'm just basically doing it for the foreign language requirement. Since I took them last year, I'm basically used to what it was like. The only difference was now we were actually in a classroom setting as opposed to the Zoom kind of interface learning that I did for both quarters in winter and spring last year. I'd say taking this new Spanish class in a classroom environment as opposed to Zoom was definitely different, of course. I was able to actually see my professor and speak with her and ask her questions without always having to kind of battle everyone for the mic. As much as I think the busy work in foreign language classes are ridiculous and completely unnecessary, I did really enjoy my professor's kind of teaching methods and the way she specifically taught our class. Overall, I ended Spanish 121-1 with an A. It was barely an A. I got right on the cutoff. I don't even remember the grade. It may have been 92.6 or something. So I was really, really close to the cutoff. I appreciated my teacher for giving that. I did think I learned a good amount for the most part. I'm gonna have to take the second and third sequence going into winter and spring this year. After spring quarter this year, I'll be done with Spanish. But overall, I'd say it was a good class, even though there was a ton of busy work and I didn't love every minute of it. So the next class I took was Business Institutions 301, which was accounting. Now this was my first real introduction to the world of finance and the world of business as a whole. I've never really taken a business class before. Obviously my high school didn't offer any of those. They didn't really even offer economics classes. So this was the first kind of intro for me, and I think it was a pretty great class to start with. Overall, the class is quite difficult, especially because it's a 300 level class, and if we're thinking of things in the traditional sense, 300 level is usually associated with a junior level type of difficulty. However, sophomores are encouraged to take it because that's kind of the class that is the first sequence into the business institutions minor, which was the main reason I was doing it. Now, the class is really cool because it's kind of different. You have tables that you just sit at on the first day, and those are your tables for the class. And with those tables, you work on in-class projects and kind of exercises and case studies. And I think it's really cool because you get to meet people, and you're never really alone when you're working on a problem or trying to understand a concept. Now, for the assessments of the class, it comes with a quarter-long project, which you could pick your group for. It's a six-person group, and I just chose some of my friends. We worked on picking a company and evaluating its financial statements and talking about specific types of ratios. And our company, and specifically, was Activision Blizzard, which is a video game publishing company. We chose that just because we didn't really know a ton about it, and we wanted to learn more. So that was really exciting. So there are also two exams for this class. One is worth 33%. That's the first one. The second one, which is kind of like the final, is worth 37%. The project that I just spoke about is worth 20%. And then homework and case studies and stuff like that are worth 10%. So the fact that this class had a huge emphasis on the assessments, especially the exams, kind of killed me because I didn't do well on them. For both exams, I did well below the average, and I just did poorly in general. It's not because they were super difficult. I actually knew all the concepts. I just didn't study for as long as I should have, and I just missed some of the things that were covered. And the time constraints were definitely tough for me specifically because I was spending too much time on one question, and it killed me at the end. Now, as much as this class was probably one of the more difficult ones for me, I will say that I learned the most out of all of my classes, for sure. The world of business is very large, and it's expanding every single day. And being able to actually understand and analyze financial statements and seeing if a company is profitable and understanding specific terms and ratios that people in finance and consulting and marketing and accounting say every single day was very, very eye-opening and very helpful for me. Overall, I ended the class with a C, which was very generous because I didn't deserve that at all. My actual grade on Canvas was well below that. I don't remember the specific percentage, but it definitely wasn't in that range. So I think the curve probably helped me with that. For most of the class, I was at 80%, and the final kind of knocked me down. And then fortunately, my group, we didn't really do great on the project, which was disappointing because we thought it was really cool and exciting to really just work on. But you know, this is what happens with life. But for the most part, I will say that I did learn a ton, and I'm very grateful for taking this class regardless. All right, so the next class I took was RTVF 190. This is, I think, media production it's called, or media construction. I can't totally remember the name. Now, I think the one main reason that I love this class so much was because of my professor. Eric Gernand at Northwestern is one of the top professors in the school. He's very sociable, a very people person type of figure, and he's very easy to approach. And I really appreciate that for someone who is kind of teaching in this realm and field. This class was really fun for me because we were able to create content and make films, and we were also able to work on crews of 3 to 4 people, which was really exciting because I've always been someone who's worked by myself, so being able to work with teams was awesome. You're basically graded on films and slight participation. Participation is worth 10%. The first film you make is worth also 10%. The next one's worth 25%, and then the last one's worth 55%. That's the bulk of the class. In addition to working on those projects throughout the quarter, we also have lectures twice a week where we do a lot of screenings and talk about specific concepts. But if you're just wanting to take a class where you're really hands-on and you get to use material and cameras and equipment, microphones, lighting, and stuff like that, definitely take RTVF 190. I think it's really fun. And I think it's just really exciting. I can't totally remember if it's reserved for RTVF majors or minors, but if it's not, definitely consider taking it. I ended the class with an A. And for the final class, which was RTVF 220, this was media analysis, or analyzing media texts, I think it was called. I think this class was relatively straightforward. We read text and we watched specific films and analyzed them in essays. It was just a lot of responses. I think I wrote like 10 responses and then like 3 or 4 papers. So it's a writing intensive class. You have 2 lectures and then a discussion. So there was a good amount of class too, and I think it was actually about 2 hours long. So there were long lectures. One lecture you would do a screening, the other you would talk about it, and the discussion you would go over the response or the paper that was due in the upcoming week. Overall, I thought the class was fine. I didn't really have any problems with it. I like my TA for the most part. The professor was very knowledgeable about the content, and the films we were discussing and analyzing. I'd say if you want to take a class that isn't super high stakes and you like writing, I would consider taking RTVF 220. I ended the class with an A, and overall it was a pretty good experience. Overall though, I've come into college with the idea and mindset that I want to take classes not strictly just for grades, but to really better understand concepts and knowledge about my real world and about phenomenons in general. I think doing that is a really good step in understanding discipline and realizing that you can't always get perfect grades, but if you're able to take something away from the class, then I'd say that was an achievement in its own way. All right, the video is getting a little long, so I don't want to keep rambling, but I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I really appreciate you guys sticking around and clicking on the video. If you enjoyed the video, please like it, subscribe, comment, share it, do whatever you can just to help kind of increase my community and viewership. I'd really appreciate that. If you guys have any ideas for new videos for either the end of this year or the beginning of next year, I really appreciate it. Put it down in a comment. Reach out to me if you have any questions about anything, college admissions, life, anything like that. I'd love to talk to you guys. Overall, I hope you guys are staying safe, staying strong. Always remember to stay motivated. And I'll see you guys in the next video.